Welcome to WEDF United. This is Smokey. I'm going solo on this show, so y'all gonna be hearing a lot of me. So let's get ready to for it. Regal comes to the ring right now. I'm not for sure if this is gonna be an interesting match, but based on Heath Slater's last opponent, didn't last too long. But most people know Heath Slater's a joke. So let's see if Regal can beat him down. I'm speechless. It's been a long night. I had a long night partying last night, folks. So if I sound a little bit off, that's why. Here comes the so-called one-man rock band, Heath Slater. Well, last time we saw him, I was in a matchup with him. It didn't last very long. I felt bad for the guy. You know, he worked his way up, get all the way to here just to get his ass whooped every match. It's his fault, though. We got a great lineup for tonight, though. We got this match, and then the next match is going to be Jeff Hardy versus the Hurricane. This will be a good match because, you know, they had a match before that. Whatever, but here we go. Heath Slater. I've botched it over the place already. We just started the show. We better get used to that, though. Look at Heath Slater going to punches, but Regal just knocked him outside the ring just like that. Heath Slater trying to grab the foot, but nah. Well, Regal was smarter than that. He got a lot of veteran ring presence here in WEDF, and he showed it. Look at that back body drop. What is he getting? It's an underhook. He just got him by the arms and a slam. Powerful slams and Slater, oh, and a chop to the back. And a European uppercut. And they're facing off again. Regal throws, what's his name, to the corner and a back slam. To all the people who ain't used to hearing me on commentating, I'm going to botch a bunch of moves. So, I don't care what anybody thinks of how I commentate. So, but back to the match. Oh, and a chop and another one. And you just hit him with a continuous chop and throws him to the toilet, turnbuckle, and just a punch to the dead of his jaw. And I think he's going for another one of those underhook slams, and he connects. But we're going to have Jeff Hardy versus the Hurricane after this. Then we're going to have Sin Cara versus Drew McIntyre and DiBiase. And a triple threat. Triple threat. There we go. And then we're gonna have Robert Van Dam versus Booker T. Not Robert Van Dam versus Booker T. See, I'm busting already. Rob Van Dam and Booker T versus Yoshi, Tatsu, and Trent, Baretta, who just formed their tag team. And I think we gotta go back to the match, folks. My bad. And it looks like it's Regal setting up for us. He got him. And the Regal Blitz, or whatever he calls it. One, two, three, and Heath Slater has failed once again. I mean, damn. I guess Regal took his frustrations out from Wade there onto Heath Slater in this matchup because Heath Slater just didn't stand a chance in this matchup. Regal, whatever point you're trying to prove, I gotta think he proved it very well in this matchup. Wow. Total domination. Heath Slater, I feel bad for him this year. He got a lot to go on up to do and a lot of training to do if he's gonna fight against anybody in WWE. What is that? WEDL. But we're about to take a commercial break in just a second. You're gonna be back, and we're gonna see a lot more boxes from you. So, stay tuned.
And we are back.
There's a hurricane. And, you know, I have another commentator here with me, but you know, Miss Frank Dog, introduce yourself. You've been gone for a while, so taking yourself back.
Yes, this is the voice of WEDF Frank Dog, and we're live here on WEDF United. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing all right. I haven't had a long start to this show, and I'm glad you came up here to help me out, and I really appreciate it.
Anyway, this is a little warm-up match here for Lashing Back 3, as Jeff Hardy is taking on the Hurricane. Both men are really good friends with each other. Tell me about that.
I'm not really for sure, because I don't really pay attention to these two guys, because I'm on a...
I mean, they grew up in, they grew up in North Carolina together. They've been friends since childhood. I mean, these two know each other like brothers.
Yeah, it's kind of like me and my friend, Justin. But friendship is closer than anything. But when you put it don't matter when you're in a match against each other or with each other. You put that all aside and you put it all in the ring.
That is correct.
If you don't, friendships would be destroyed.
There's something about Jeff Hardy is that he's wanting to prove something to Zach Starr that he can go home for home as well. Because remember, on the last night, Jeff Hardy watched the Zach Starr beat Kofi Kingston, a former WEDF champion. Tell you what,
but he can't look.
Wants to prove he can go home for home as well with Zach Starr.
He can't look after this match, though. Hurricane's a good competitor.
Jeff Hardy is a former three-time Intercontinental champion.
And he goes after them legs.
That's a good strategy.
Yeah, I was surprised to hear on my headset that you was in the back. That's the reason I got you out here. I made you come out here for old time's sake.
Oh, Jeff Hardy with a spinning heel kick there. Jeff Hardy wants to...
Who do you think is the favorite in this matchup?
I've got to go with Jeff Hardy. He's got a lot more to prove. Did Zach Starr come lashing back? He wants to... Because the walls would hurt Jeff Hardy in this situation.
We got the pin already.
No, just out there, ladies and gentlemen. Jeff Hardy has got to beat Zach Starr because if Zach Starr comes in with a lot of momentum and Jeff Hardy is coming in with a wall, that's going to hurt Jeff Hardy.
Oh, yeah. Quick, if you don't get momentum in this match, and especially since Hurricane's dangerous, he's quick. And Jeff Hardy just got to stay in his mindset where he needs to just get momentum and not anything else. No flashiness, no nothing. Get the victory.
Oh, wait a second. Oh, Jeff Hardy for a power bomb. I got counter in midair. Just a one count right there.
Wow.
I mean, Hurricane knows.
Like
I said, Hurricane knows Jeff Hardy so well. I mean, there's no
need. I went for the drop kick, but no.
The long Hurricane bouncing off the rope.
Like he was gonna do something, chasing my monkey flip.
Jeff Hardy anticipated something coming. That was maybe a little fake out than death.
Yeah, I'm not for sure if you saw that last match in the back when you came out here, but I just feel bad for Heath Slater. He just one loss after another after another.
I knew what was coming. Anyway,
everybody kind of.
But Jeff Hardy coming back.
Oh!
Nice DDT by Jeff. Falls out with a dropkick. Jeff Hardy is gaining fire.
And it goes with the punches in the right hand. It just crumbled him over the head continuously. And Hurricane is reeling right now. Look at this.
Final dropkick.
Three more dropkicks.
Jeff
Hardy. Wow, I thought Hurricane's out.
Hurricane reversal. Like Jeff Hardy.
But look at this. He can't.
Hurricane, another monkey flip. Hurricane not giving up here.
Hurricane's what tough. Oh, he hits the bulldog and he goes for the pin. That's one thing about Hurricane. He's tougher than what people give him credit for.
Oh, yes. He's a former longest running cruiserweight champion of all time. You can't get him out. But Jeff Hardy.
Head, no.
Back suplex from the Extreme Enigma.
Wait a second, what is he setting up for here?
Power slam. Will this be it? Another cover, one, two, and again.
Oh, no. They're kind of like a modified World's Strongest Man slam, by the way.
I don't want to talk about Mark Henry, because if I talk stuff about him, he'll probably come after me and make me join the Hall of Pain.
I'm already in it, so I already know.
Anyway, back to this match. Another monkey foot. That's like the third one of this match.
I don't know, but look at Jeff Hardy's trying to fight back here. A European uppercut.
Jeff Hardy coming back. Wait, reversal. Wait, Jeff Hardy.
Oh,
wait. Up in Jeff Hardy. We got to cover. One, two, and Hurricane kicks out.
Oh, it's amazing how he can just, you know, he can just pull off moves like that.
Jeff Hardy was going for Twitter fate. Like, Hurricane was thinking...
He went for the grapple, but missed.
Hurricane Rana!
He goes for the pin!
Somebody went for early, but missed. Can he do it? No!
No!
Wait.
Wow, very close. Between these two.
You got dead! What is Jeff
Hardy? Wow, he goes to the turnbuckle.
Freaking way! I mean, he's got to do this with Lashing Back.
Going at... Oh, DDT. There's for the pin.
We got to cover one. Two and a kick out. Because at WrestleMania, Jeff Hardy beat Zach Starr in Extreme Rules. Zach Starr's been so mad about that.
Yeah, it was a crazy matchup. I'm even sitting in the back because that's back whenever I first got back, basically. And them two amazed me in the ring. It's amazing how far they have came.
Hurricane went for something.
It is.
But man, Jeff Hardy. Oh, man.
Now, flip thing move. Whatever it's called.
Twist of fate!
And that's gotta be it. Well, he could have been setting up for it.
I don't think Jeff is done. Jeff going up high. High risk.
He connects with the spot time.
Jeff Hardy. Here's the cover. One, two, three. Jeff Hardy is rolling, heading into Lashing Back.
And that's a great momentum boost. Especially facing against the Hurricane and doing that.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at this replay. Hurricane was a tough challenge here for Jeff Hardy tonight. You see that Hurricane Rana right there. Jeff Hardy had to crawl and fight, just like how he will have to do at Lashing Back. But Jeff Hardy might be the underdog in that match.
Yeah, but it don't matter if you're underdog or you're the favorite. You got to go out there and put it all on the line.
Yes, that's Swanton Bomb. Jeff Hardy got the cover on the Hurricane, beating one of the people he knows. I mean, this was no easy task for Jeff Hardy, but it's only going to get harder at Lashing Back. Can he get the job done? Yes. But what Jeff Hardy got to do to get to win that match, he's got to find out at the Click Review.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we will be right back from this commercial break. So, ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned.
See, this part of y'all motherfuckers hating. And for all y'all motherfuckers getting hated on. Soon as I step up in the club, meme of me. I don't give a fuck, man. I'm Smokey. Most of y'all really wanna be me. I grim, I laugh, I'm a nobody. Give you something to mean mug, man. Look at my shoes, 200 bucks. Now look at my belt, 200 mean mug. Cause I use this thing here to strike your girl butt. And if you wanna pop them things, we click the. We 50-50 deep, yeah, all mean mug. So get to pick a plan or your grave getting dug. I know most I behind mean mug. See, I'm so fly and I'm so trill, man. Even my whip got a mean mug and grip. We can do it too, man. Get behind me, 50-50, me mugging you, not me mug. I keep a girl big clips, me mug. Every week, four or five different whips, me mug. If she wanna take a ride, don't trip, me mug. Big stacks, rubber bands, no clips, me mug. Now go ahead and me mug.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you back to the United, and you're all over the place.
Man, I ain't seen that in ages.
Anyway, gentlemen, we have a triple threat match for the television championship. Both general managers, the anonymous general manager of Raw and the new general manager of SmackDown, I believe. No, it was Teddy Long. He's still GM of SmackDown. Have agreed to this match here, this interpromotional match, since the television championship is interpromotional. It will be a triple threat match. Here's
the match.
One of the challengers for this television championship. And you know, he's got a lot of beef with one of the other challengers in this match, Ted DiBiase. Remember, a few rounds ago, DiBiase beat McIntyre after McIntyre taunted too much. And it cost him the match in the end. You see, that could costly, that might be something that hurt McIntyre and DiBiase, as they can't count out the television champion, Sin Cara.
Sin Cara, he's a champ for a reason, and he got a lot of quickness to him, and it won't take no time for him to get them 11 in this match if they both suck on each other's egos.
Well, remember, in this match, Sin Cara doesn't have to be pinned or have to submit to lose the television championship. And here comes Sin Cara, who defeated Alvaro Mexico at WrestleMania 2. But on the tribute to the troops, Chavo Guerrero was named number one contender. Chavo Guerrero still hasn't informed us when he'll cash in that number one contender spot. We know if Sin Cara loses, Chavo Guerrero can still cash in that number one contender spot whenever he chooses. But not,
and that's the advantage. And that's the advantage he got.
It might not be against Sin Cara. Sin Cara has to get a loose at first. Here comes the Southern Gentleman.
And here comes Ted DiBiase,
who is deemed to turn over a new leaf, who is deemed to become a fan favorite here. Tell me about how Ted DiBiase maybe showed a sign of that at WrestleMania 2.
Yeah, he got a lot of things to do before he get there though, because an ego is still an ego if you look at it, but people can change. But he had to keep on it and showing people that he is willing to change for the good.
However, Ted DiBiase doesn't want to live in the shadow of his own father. He wants to become his own man. And that advice, that gives me a little bit of respect there for Ted DiBiase.
Yeah. And especially who his dad is. It's kind of tough to be in somebody's shadow like that. I don't know how that is, but I imagine it's pretty tough. But we'll see. The match is about to get underway.
Television championship on the line. This match, I believe, is going to be all over the place.
And let's get ready for it all.
Bell rings and this match is underway. And
here we go.
McIntyre and DiBiase. And
McIntyre.
Too aggressive there. He's going right after DiBiase. McIntyre still peaking after losing to DiBiase. Was a Raw 185, I believe.
I kind of disagree with this. But he is a big man, but I would take out Sin Cara first.
Hey, if I'm Sin Cara, I just watched this match. I mean, these two beat the hell out of each other. But Sin Cara's not like that. He's a fighter. He's a fighting champion. He'll take on all comers.
And he slammed the knee and Sin Cara with a spinning head scissors.
What's it like for Sin Cara?
Oh, that's not the one.
Sin Cara is rolling. Look at him go for the... DiBiase and McIntyre. Looks like they were teaming up for a little bit, but that wasn't going to happen.
I don't think there really is no strategy when it comes to McIntyre. I just think he wants a piece of DiBiase in the looks of it. Oh, and a power slam. Big snap.
Big power slam by McIntyre. And this vicious, sinister Scotsman is just taking it.
They just going back and forth with the punches. What is DiBiase doing?
Look at DiBiase. What's he thinking? Snake eyes. Hey, Sin Cara.
Here goes for the pin!
What?
He missed it!
Oh no!
Oh, that was close. McIntyre was getting too ahead of himself now. Oh, look at that back elbow!
Great ball, back elbow!
Exactly. That's what I said.
It's, I believe, it's Sin Cara's first defense as television champion since winning the belt at WrestleMania 2. It's Sin Cara so far.
And this is going to be a tough matchup with this. Look at that shoulder into the abdomen.
Sin Cara has been on the band for losing streak, so he's got to be careful. Irish whip in the corner.
Can't be too comfortable. What's he doing?
Get Sin Cara just flying all around the ring.
And he went for elbow, but he just completely... And he's hitting the ghost, apparently.
Way too aggressive here.
Yeah, I think he got a hold of my stash in the back. I don't know. He's acting weird. Oh, and he just dropped down the arm.
Just attacking the arm right there.
I hit a foot scissors. I'm calling that. I'm calling the foot scissors because I got to grab him by his foot.
Like DiBiase. Look at McIntyre on the outside. DiBiase and Sin Cara going at it. Gut wrench suplex. Watch out for McIntyre from behind. DiBiase fighting out of it. Look at DiBiase. But Sin Cara coming back. Sin Cara.
Damn, keep photoing him.
Will this be it? Will Sin Cara retain? But McIntyre right there to break.
Oh, dude, this is gonna be a tough match to win because you got a quick guy and you got two powerful guys.
Yeah, single them out too. Wait, he bounced one for something, but McIntyre counters with an inverse DDT and McIntyre. Oh,
wait a second.
Face first.
And that's gotta be it. That was a powerful move.
And a kick out.
He kicked out of that.
Right before DiBiase was able to save it. DiBiase gets
a close one. DiBiase will be Sin Cara will be worried in this matchup.
Like Sin Cara behind. Hurricanrana.
He's with a pin.
One. Two. And again, McIntyre couldn't break it up. But DiBiase managed to kick out.
What is this? Another hand scissors.
Another one.
He's going crazy with his head scissors tonight.
And DiBiase.
And here comes DiBiase.
Too early. You know when McIntyre's behind you, it's a bad choice to go for a submission.
DiBiase just came into this match with temper. I kind of like that in a way. It's going to backfire. It could backfire on him, but I like his enthusiasm in this match. Oh, look at that. Backflip. He just walked all over him.
And a Hurricanrana. Sin Cara is rumbling now. Another Hurricanrana.
Another spinning head scissors.
Well, Sin Cara gained momentum, trying to find a way to... Wait, here's a reversal. Oh!
Oh, it is. It's tossed him to him. Down in the belly.
And then there was an inadvertent teamwork. Wait a minute. McIntyre. Is it time to set up for the future shock DDT? Is McIntyre becoming the television champion? Look at that.
He got him locked in.
Future Shock DDT. Wait a minute.
Sin Cara stand him up.
Sin Cara from behind. Wait. Babinsica. Babinsica's locked in.
They got him locked.
Go.
He tapped.
Right before DiBiase.
Oh.
Ave it nonetheless.
Wow, I'm shocked by that. I did not.
What a way for Sin Cara to retain the television championship. He picked his spot. That's what it takes to win in a triple threat. He said McIntyre, he thought he might have had the match won.
I thought so too. Look at that Hurricanrana pin right there.
What an impressive victory for Sin Cara, ladies and gentlemen. You thought McIntyre for that future shock DDT, but Sin Cara, that last wind of life, was able to hit my Mystica right here during this replay. Maybe we'll have Drew McIntyre be forced to submit. You know, McIntyre's not too happy about tapping here. He had no choice.
Oh, no. He was in the middle of the ring.
And DiBiase.
There was nowhere to go.
DiBiase was unable to save it. Just not able to be there in time.
Well, all the people was wondering how Sin Cara would react during this match, and he has proved to be a champion.
Very impressive champion is Sin Cara. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we got a commercial break. We'll be right back after this commercial from your local sponsor.
Tokyo.
And we're back, ladies and gentlemen, and here comes one of Wally's favorite superstars, Carpenter Wally's, Yoshi Tatsu. This is a rough man.
Wally's got a special mind for him. So.
Anyway, Yoshi Tatsu is going to be joined by a new tag team partner, Trent Baretta, to face off against Booker T and Rob Van Dam, another new tag team. Actually, they are former tag team champions in WWE.
That's going to be a...
Both of these tag teams.
Trent Baretta is it kind of went into a storm and the guy here. I took a mock into him. He got a good future. NWEF.
He beat Wade.
Let's see how he had a tag team action here tonight.
Trent Baretta beat Wade Barrett in a single match on ECW a couple of months ago. Yoshi Tatsu.
Yeah, exactly. I remember that.
Yoshi Tatsu wasn't a tag team with Suspect. Not much success there, but I mean, maybe this partnership between Yoshi and Trent could work, but they're against a veteran tag team of Booker T and Rob Van Dam, who actually were former tag team champions, beating Evolution back in 2003, I believe.
Wow, that's a long time ago. But they're veterans, and they got a lot of in-ring presence, and as you said, they got history together. So it's going to be kind of tough for this new tag team to come out here and pull out an upset, but we've seen it before, and we can't run out at all.
The Yoshi Tatsu working on. Now the Yoshi Tatsu and Trent Baretta both nearly beat Batista on episodes of Flame. See Booker T, the former King of the Ring winner, the former two-time United States champion, the former six-time world champion, the former five-time WCW champion.
And I can dig that.
Well, can you?
Yes, I can. And can you dig it, though?
Oh, yeah. Anyway, here comes Rob Van Dam, and like I said, both of these tag teams are looking to get the tag team title hunt, and with a victory, and whoever wins this will no doubt get in that tag team title hunt, but they've got to be looking at Jericho and Million Dollar Congregation unification match at Lashing Back 3. And whoever wins this,
that could be a crazy match
for the winner of that match.
If Baretta and Tatsu can pull off an upset mix matchup, I think they'll have a good chance going after that and going for even higher goals like a unified tag team title. You never know.
Those tag team titles will be unified at Lashing Back 3. So tag teams in WEDF are going to be much harder to win because there's going to be so many challengers, just so many tag teams trying to fight for just one tag team championship, not two anymore, just one.
And Booker T wins the square off, and he goes for that elbow, and he got him back in the tie-up. And he goes for another one, but Tatsu is ready for it, using his quickness to his advantage, which will be both of them needs to use their quickness in the matchup, because Booker T is a powerful guy. Robert Damon, you said he himself.
There's a dropkick by Yoshi Tatsu. Yoshi Tatsu and Trent have the youth in this match. And they've got to use that to their advantage. They got to get quick and getting quick tags and keeping these veterans in the same corner.
Oh,
worn down. Yeah. Will be some advice I could give for Yoshi Tatsu and Trent Baretta.
And he just made the mistake right there trying to go head to head with Booker T. Right there, and I called him Booger T for some reason, but he needs to stay on his feet and stay away from the ball and style.
But he didn't go for the cover.
Wow. Hey, takes in RVD.
Rob Van Dam is in this match now. Rob Van Dam.
Oh, with a
springboard back kick, and now Rob Van Dam is rolling.
Golden light.
And this is our main event, ladies and gentlemen. What? No.
Rob Van Dam, he's a crappy veteran, I tell you. He's dangerous at any time, high flying,
Oh, it's just green prison.
Yoshi Tatsu coming back with those kicks. Like a Yoshi.
And he just swings, pulls him off the ropes. Wow.
Yoshi's
fucking him. Tatsu can get Baretta in his matchup.
Wait a minute.
Oh! I can't remember the Chinese name for that, the Japanese name for that move, but I know it looked like a backflip into a DDT. There I go again. DDT. I mean, not DDT, though. You know what I'm talking about, whatever.
Alex Shelley does for the Motor City Machine Guns.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, that big body drop. And this is the guy I'm looking forward to right here. He puts a lot of excitement into a matchup, and I just would be amazed to see what he can do in this matchup.
In his work at True to the Truth, where he nearly beat Chavo Guerrero to earn a number one contender TV title. You remember that?
I remember it to this very day. But it's like every single matchup he could win. He just got to grow in his company and learn, you know, not to go too far. Oh, and the spear in the clothesline. Oh, he's out.
Days of the damage gauge. Oh.
And he does the fisherman suplex. Shades of Mr. Perfect almost. The late great Mr. Perfect.
Bandana coming back. Oh! In fury.
Straight to the back of the head.
Rob Van Dam, what's he going for? Rob Van Dam, I tell you what, he's rolling.
On the hell, Corona! And the referees, I think Booker T trying to distract him.
Wait, Rob Van Dam!
He's going to set up for
like a month ago. Vintage Rob Van Dam! And now you see the veteran of Booker T and Rob Van Dam coming into play.
Holy crap, that he put some force into it, that's gotta be it. No Baretta got over there quick enough.
And Booker T another.
It's in the old days they called it, he called the Harlem kick.
Let's see,
I might be wrong,
ladies and gentlemen, to get the momentum back for his tag team.
And he throws him back in the corner. We're chopped to the chest. I think he needs a tag and keep the freshman in, and he does.
And wait a minute, what are they going for here? Oh! Right on that top.
Oh, no!
Wait
a second. I don't know if that's an accident.
No, I think that was an accident. I don't think Trent Baretta knew what he was doing. It could be costly.
Oh yeah, that's a rookie mistake for you right there. They got a rebound from this in order to stay against them, cause Booker T can change it in a heartbeat.
Booker T with the D to the gut. Now Booker T, look at this. Another kick right to the face, and now Booker T is rolling.
Yeah, knee to the midsection.
Attack the
Booker
T. Teamwork.
You don't want to. Oh, look at this! Another one of those kicks from the ropes.
This match is so high, fast paced that anything can happen. Trent Baretta is in big, big trouble. I mean, that one mistake by Bulldog is his own teammate might have called for the match. We got to cover. Rep, wait.
What the heck is the ref doing?
I think Yoshi Tatsu was distracting the referee.
There's a lot of stuff going on in the ring right now, and he takes back in Booker T.
Tag. It's two are keeping each other fresh with those quick tags and keeping the Trent singled out from his partner. Back body drop right there.
And you notice the veterans and the rookies, they making sure nothing don't mess up the momentum in their match.
Here's the reversal. Back body drop. This could be a
big body drop.
You gotta go for the tag.
He's going for. Oh, reverse DDT.
You've got to go for the tag. There you go. Hit the tag. Tatsu.
And is Tatsu standing up for something here? He's gonna connect.
Oh!
Oh, and he connects.
But Yoshi's not done. He's got. Look. Oh, Yoshi!
It's gotta be a win!
But Booker's out of it! Oh, Booker!
Just too much strength. Too much strength.
Now, Irish whip. Booker. Wait, Yoshi coming back! Yoshi not giving up! Yoshi feeling it! Can he find a way to put Booker T away? Will this lead to a future tag team title shot after Lashing Back 3? Booker T find him. Oh!
Oh, and a big boom straight to the head.
Yoshi with
it. Yoshi's still trying to fight.
What?
Big elbow.
Another.
And another one.
Oh. Will this be it? Can we hear something? Two, and Rob's standing right there to break it up. And now all hell is breaking loose in the ring.
Baretta just comes to time. Both these teams want to make an impact and show that they are worthy of the tag team title.
Mike's wait. Yoshi Rob's trying to fight back here. Oh!
Oh, in the back! And Booker T is dazed!
Look at the teamwork they
work. He has a hold of them!
The teamwork between Yoshi Tatsu and... Oh, Booker T fighting back though. Oh!
Oh! And... Oh, and another big boom!
Booker T, six.
Hey, can he be standing up?
Booking! Royal Booking!
Booking! Booking! That's gotta be it!
This
and that was the nail on the coffin.
Two and Trevor are unable to make it in time.
Wow.
That's the veteran instincts there of Booker T and Rob Van Dam. But what a performance by Yoshi Tatsu and Trent Baretta, though. You gotta give them that.
Oh yeah, they put all the heart on the line. Just they need to learn some things in order to keep from mistakes like that happening. So it'll be interesting to see how their future holds and see if they hold on.
He's a singles competitor most of the time, and that singles competitor veteran instinct basically helps them win the match here.
Oh yeah. This has been an excellent show. I enjoyed it.
Get off of that booking. Booker T, just with that booking hitting it and then getting a 1-2-3. See, Trent Baretta was not able to break it up in time. But anyway, what a great match here. Booker T and Rob Van Dam are eyeing whoever comes out of Jericho versus the Congregation match as their future opponent. Anyway, Smokey, this is Frank Dog, and this might be my last appearance till like Summerfest or something, but anyway, good night, ladies.
I'm still here, baby.
And we will see you sometime. Don't know when, don't know as, don't know.
We will be. We'll be here somewhere.
Thanks for Lashing Back.